In the previous lessons, we discussed how to reuse functionality by referencing other modules. In this lesson, we will see the benefits of using modules and how adding references influences the application footprint. Let's see first why you should use modules. By splitting functionality into modules, you are creating an abstraction that hides the module's implementation and it's easier to use. So abstraction is the first benefit of using modules. You also isolate functionality, making it easier to test and to maintain. So isolation is the second benefit. Third, it will be easier to manage complexity as you will be tackling smaller problems. So using modules allows you to manage the complexity of the problem at hand. And finally, having different modules leads to more efficient teamwork. Developers are not always stepping on each other's toes as they can work on different modules at the same time. So these are the benefits of using modules. And in order to use modules to build our application, we need to use references between those modules. So we need to understand the impact of having references between modules in the application footprint. So let's try to understand what happens when we create a reference. And let's use our e-billing application as an example. So you recall from the previous lessons that we referenced the suppliers module from the e-billing module and also the Google static map module. To be able to run this application, the code of the reference modules, the code of the suppliers module and the Google static map is also included in the application. So when we publish the e-billing application, we have the code of the e-billing module, we have the code of the suppliers module, and we have the code of the Google static map. I'm drawing these with different sizes because I'm assuming here that the e-billing application will have more functionality than the suppliers and more functionality than the Google static map. Now, the code of the reference modules is included so that the application can be compiled and run. Now, let's imagine that we extend the e-billing application. We are extending the e-billing application by referencing another module where we have a product entity. And basically, we want to be able to reference a product when we create a request. Now, what will happen in this case? So now when we publish the e-billing application, we have the code of the e-billing module, the code of the suppliers module, the code of the Google static map, and we also need to include, let me just highlight here, we also need to include the code of the order manager. And here, I'm drawing the order manager roughly with the same size as the e-billing application, assuming they have an equivalent amount of functionality. But when we do this, when we reference the order manager module itself also has references to other modules. Let me highlight it here. These modules here are dependencies of the order manager. So in order to publish the e-billing application to be able to compile it and run, we also need to include here all those modules that are dependencies of the order manager. And what happens here is that we are growing the footprint of the e-billing application with unnecessary code. All these dependencies here are really not necessary for the e-billing application because we only need the product entity for the e-billing application. So is there a way to avoid this inefficiency? Yes, there is. Let's take a look at the following example. In this case, we have the same e-billing application. We have also here the order manager, but the product entity that was included in the order manager module is now on its own module called products in a products application. And what happens in this case, let's go through it. To be able to publish, to compile and run the e-billing application, we need the code of the e-billing module. We will need the code of the suppliers module and also the code of the Google static map. And now that we added this reference here, this reference to the product, we also need to include the products module as well. But we don't need to include all these references here. So as you can see, this second scenario, we have a much more efficient use of the code in the e-bidding application compared to what we had in the previous example. In the next lesson, we will see a framework that helps you decide which modules to create and still avoid this problem, avoid in growing the application footprint with unnecessary code. That's it.